Hallelujah. You are welcome to today's episode. This is a woman to woman lifter, a platform for mentoring. I started a series last time on your role as a minister's wife, your role as a pastor's wife. Are you a pastor's wife? Are you a minister's wife? You have roles to play to find fulfillment in life and ministry. I'll be taking my text from Proverbs chapter 12, verse 4. A virtuous woman is a crown to her husband, but she that maketh ashamed is as rottenness in his bones. And Proverbs chapter 14, verse 1 reads, every wise woman buildeth her house, but the foolish plucketh it down with her hands. So this morning, I want to stir up your heart as a woman, as a minister's wife, to bring joy and pride to your husband. Bring joy and pride to your husband. Make him joyful, make him proud of you. And when you make your husband joyful and proud of you, of course, it will return back to you in hundredfold. It's what you sow that you reap. What you sow, you reap. What you sow, you reap. My husband will say, as long as you can, if the devil cannot stop you from sowing, he cannot stop your harvest. So if you can sow into the life of your husband in such a way that he'll be happy with you, joyful, and also he'll be proud of you, of course, there's nothing good that your husband would not do for you. A man of God who was once, he had problem with his wife, and you know, so many counseling sessions, they go through a lot of counseling sessions to see what they can do for peace to be enjoyed in their home. But, you know, they didn't achieve much. But with time, you know, teaching the wife what to do, what to avoid, and what to do to impress her husband and all that, with all the knowledge she received, she was able to adjust. Your husband too adjusted. And because both of them were willing to make adjustments because they really want to enjoy their home, both of them were willing and they make those adjustments. And then, the husband was so excited, was so happy that the wife had changed. And he was telling me, Mommy, I'm telling you, there's nothing I can do for my wife now. That there was even a time his wife was requesting for a particular sum of money, that he increased it. And eventually he even gave her his ATM card and said, go, withdraw anything you want, because he was so pleased, because her attitude towards him had changed. And he was so happy that she was bringing him joy. When a man is happy, when a man is, you know, joyful about his wife, he will be proud of her. And when he's proud of her, it's like, you know, it fulfills this scripture that says a virtuous woman is a crown. It's a crown to her husband. He will carry you everywhere. He will expose you. He will introduce you everywhere. He will be happy to have you in his life. And then he says, but she that maketh ashamed is as rottenness, like cancer in his bones, like cancer that eats him up. I remember this particular man of God, when he was having issues with his wife, that was eating him up. But when the problem was resolved and they were now happy with each other, he said, Mommy, can't you see that my tummy is coming out? He's so happy. Everything about him had changed. He said, Mommy, see my tummy. My wife is trying. So when a wife is bringing joy to her husband, he'll be able to achieve more. He'll be able to achieve his goals because nothing will trouble him. There's no trouble at all. And then he's able to enjoy peace. You know, when you have peace, ideas come easily. He's able to receive ideas on what to do for God. So, but if it's a woman that maketh ashamed, as rottenness in his bones, that you are like a cancer in the bone of your husband, oh my God, that man will be desperate. I mean, will live in frustration. He will live. I know there are men of God like that who are really frustrated because of their wives' role, what their wives are doing to them, has brought them frustration. So such women are like cancer in the bones of their husbands. I pray that will not be your portion. I pray you will not play that kind of role that will bring pains to your husband. Even if your husband is not giving you joy, why not sow the seed of joy into your husband? Bring him joy. Bring him pleasure. Bring him satisfaction. It's what you sow that you reap. Give it to him. Even if you are doing it and you are not receiving the reward, maybe you are not doing it enough, or you are not doing it well. Do it with the whole of your heart. One thing I've discovered is, if you want God to touch your husband, you must pray, you know, with love. Let your prayer go with love, not with you go to God and keep complaining about your husband. You won't get results. God will not hear your prayers. But when you go with love, you are praying for him to do well, to increase. And then you are also demonstrating that love. God will answer your prayers concerning your husband. So bring joy to your husband. Exhibit wisdom to build your home and ministry. Exhibit wisdom. Don't be a foolish woman. Exhibit wisdom. Let God give you ideas on what to do to bring joy to your husband. And for you to be able to achieve that, you know, you need to personally develop yourself. Because if you are not hearing from God, the ideas you need to bring this joy and pride may not be there. So when you go to God in prayers, spend time with the Word of God, spend time to read books, spend time to study other people. When you do that, it brings personal development, and also because you are personally developed, it helps you to behave better. You know, the deeper you go in God, the farther you go, you know, with men. The deeper you go with God, your capacity to impact lives enlarges. When you go deeper with God, your capacity to affect lives, to impact lives increases. So when you are not going deeper in God, when you are not growing spiritually, you are limited. In fact, your lack of knowledge will make you feel you are not capable. It makes you feel incapable. It makes you feel you can really not achieve much. You know, it limits you. It limits what you do. So knowledge is very impactful. Increase your knowledge. Spend time in the Word of God. Spend time to study God's Word. Spend time to identify your gifts. Know the kind of giftings God has blessed you with, and see what you can do to exercise your gifts. You know, when you exercise your gifts, it makes room for you, you know, to be honored. It makes room for you to be useful in the house of God. And it gives room for your husband to also assign you with so many things to help him, because you are his helpmeet. So if he should help you, there should be areas that you can really perform well. If you are not performing well at all in every area, then how useful will you be to your husband? So there is need for personal development. Develop yourself so that indeed you be a crown to your husband and bring him joy, bring him fulfillment, make him proud of you. And in return, you will be blessed. In return, you will be honored. In return, you'll be well positioned in life. I pray that to be your own experience in the name of Jesus. I pray that God gives you the wisdom, God gives you divine ideas on what you can do to bring joy, pleasure to your husband and make him proud of you. As you do that, God will increase you in Jesus' name. God bless you. Please, you have questions, there is a WhatsApp number on the screen. I want you to send your questions to that number, and by the grace of God, we'll answer your questions. God bless you. Hallelujah.